Good afternoon, shooting fans, and welcome back to the finals hall here in Granada, Spain, for the second final of the day, 10-meter air pistol woman. I'm Hilary Russell, and I have the pleasure of having India's one-time World Cup silver medalist, Hina Sidhu, here with me today. Welcome, Hina, and thank you so much for joining us.
Thank you, Hilary.
So, why don't you take a couple seconds and explain the new finals format for us?
This year, the finals have changed drastically. You first have to shoot two series of three shots in 2.5 minutes, that's 150 seconds. And then after six shots, you have to shoot one shot per on command for another 50 seconds. So as compared to the earlier finals, you've got 25 seconds less per shot. And then the elimination starts after eight shot. The first elimination is at eight shot, and then the athletes get eliminated after every alternate shot.
Right. And just to remind the viewers that after qualifications, the athletes come into the finals hall and their qualification score is eliminated.
Yeah.
And so everybody starts off at zero, and they really have to shoot strong for these series shots.
Yeah.
Because if you start off on the wrong foot, it's really hard to make up those points.
Yeah, the first six shots are very crucial. Because if you, the first six shots are actually the base of the whole final. If you have a good start, you know you're not going to be eliminated, so you're more at ease.
Mm-hmm.
Otherwise, you have this pressure that I might get eliminated now, now, now.
Right. Yeah. And have you been in a final? Have you tried out this final?
Yes, I have been in two finals this season.
Mm-hmm.
I was the first to get eliminated in both of them.
Oh, no.
That's why I'm saying from my experience that first six shots are really important.
Okay, all right. And let's talk about what's going on in your life. Something new has happened, hasn't it?
Yes, I got married in February.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, that's things are good.
I bet they are.
Yeah.
And you got married to a fellow shooter.
Yes, his name is Ronak Pandit, mm-hmm. and he's been helping me with my preparation as well, along with my coach.
Very nice. That's great. Well, congratulations to you both.
Yeah. Thank you.
So in just a couple of minutes, we're going to have a chance to meet our eight finalists. We've got a lot of talent here today, and we also have, I believe, one person who's never entered into a final round of a World Cup before. So it's going to be really, really interesting to see who's going to end up on the podium. In fact, it is just one person that has not. We've got about 25 more seconds of them doing sighting and preparation time, and then we'll have a chance to meet these eight talented women. I wouldn't even, knowing that with the start list that we have, I wouldn't dare put my money down on anybody, because
the according to the new rules, anybody can win.
Exactly.
Yeah, these 20 shots are actually an entirely different match, a new match.
Exactly. So they're going to be turning around facing the spectators, and we've got a full house today. It's really great to see so many people that have come to be here. And here they are, our eight finalists. And in firing point eight, representing the People's Republic of China, we have Gao Wenjun.
She's been holding the Olympic gold since 2008.
Yeah, so
she is very good.
Okay. She is. She's cute. Then on firing point G, representing Belarus, we have Victoria Shaika.
She's another very experienced player, and she got the World Cup gold in the last World Cup match in Munich. She did very well there.
Very, very well. On firing point F, representing Mexico, we have Alejandra Zavala.
She, I think this is her first World Cup final, and it's really good to see somebody from Mexico.
It really is.
Yeah.
You're absolutely right. On firing point E, representing Serbia, we have Zorana Aranovic.
Yeah, she's the reigning world champion.
Yeah, she is, and she's a great person.
Yeah.
Just won the bronze yesterday in 25-meter pistol.
Yeah. Yes, she did.
And on firing point D, representing the Russian Federation, we have Galina Orlovskaya.
Another experienced player we have here. She's been shooting since many years.
She certainly has. In fact, she started competing. We're practicing as a shooter when she was in 1984. On firing point C, representing France, we have Céline Gauberry.
She has been doing exceptionally well since the past 2 or 3 years. And she even won the Olympic silver in London.
On firing point B, representing Spain, we have Sonia Franquet.
Another experienced shooter, as we can see.
And she definitely has the spectators behind her, being on her own home turf.
This is her home ground.
And on firing point A, representing the Republic of Korea, we have Jang Mi Kim.
If I'm not wrong, she has an Olympic medal.
She does. She has it in 25 meters,
right?
Yes, exactly. And she's had a fantastic season so far. She's won the gold in Fort Benning and the bronze in Shangwang. So it's really a lot of incredible talent out there. And we're going to get this going very, very soon. And it'll be great to see how it's going to pan out. Do you suppose that these women are quite nervous right now?
I think everybody is.
Yeah.
It doesn't matter how experienced you are, you always get some butterflies in your tummy. Yeah. It's just the skill lies in the way they handle the pressure.
That's right.
Yeah.
And there's some of these women we've seen in finals before, and you can see that they really can take it emotionally. You can see it right on their face. Where I'd have to say the People's Republic of China, the athletes from there, they can keep a very, very steady face, and you can't read what's going through their minds.
Yeah.
This is Jang Mi Kim. She has got the smallest hands. They're so petite, and so they're really amazing to see. That she holds this pistol is so huge in these teeny hands.
Asian women are smaller.
Yeah, absolutely. Yeah.
And so am I.
You are. You're teeny. So again, we've got 150 seconds to shoot these three shots. And then we'll be going on to the single shots. And those, you have 50 seconds to shoot. All right, we're just going to take a look here at Kim. She definitely has a signature way of standing and holding herself. You know, everybody's got a little bit different.
Yes.
But it's almost like she's resting her head on her shoulder.
Yeah. I can see a little movement in her hand. Maybe she's a little nervous.
A little bit nervous.
Who's not on the first shot?
Looks like Franquette is just waiting for the right moment. She's definitely taking her time.
Yeah.
Gauberry coming off of a 10.8. That's a fantastic way to start off this final. And you could see her hand was shaking a little bit too.
Yeah, and she did the right thing by canceling that shot.
Franquette starting off with a 9.8.
Not bad.
Mm-hmm. 9.3 for Gauberry. Something must be up. And do you think it's difficult to start off with such a great shot, a 10.8? Do you think that...
I think you cannot control where you shoot. Mm-hmm. You know, you don't know what is 10.8 and 10.9. Excuse me. But a shooter does know that this was a good shot and this was a bad shot. So 10.8 can be good, can be bad, but
okay.
She did a really good job. 9.3, maybe the pressure was building.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
So we're seeing quite a few shots here in the nines. And we're just going to have to take a look and see what the standings are. Unfortunately, we had a 7.8 there for Orlovskaya. And Franquette shooting all in the nines here. Let's take a look now at the standings after the first series. We have Kim holding on to first place only by 3/10 of a point. Zavala, this is surprising, never entering into a final round of a World Cup, and she is in second place. And 7/10 of a point behind her, we have Arunavich. Orlovskaya right now is in eighth place, and she's got, what, we've got five more shots to find out. Yeah. 1.8 of a point. Do you think that's kind of hard to get back, or we're just going to have to wait for the next series?
Yeah, three shots are a lot. Mm-hmm. And I don't know, I've noticed one thing about these finals. Ever since the rules changed, I've seen a lot of sevens coming up from people.
Well, what do you suppose that the reason for that is?
I don't know. I really don't know, because I think the pressure is about the same, mm-hmm. and these shots are like any other qualification match, you know?
Right.
Three shots like the qualification match. But something is up, and I'm seeing a lot of sevens coming from both the girls and the guys.
Okay.
I don't know if you've noticed that.
I have noticed it, as a matter of fact, and I've been wondering what really is going on here.
Yeah.
You know, Franquette right now with an 8.7, Zavala with a 10.3. That's a nice way to start off the first series. Maybe it is just the fact that the men and women are nervous. They know that they have to do really well for these first two series. Because
everybody is starting from the same point, and anybody can win.
Right.
Yeah.
9.6 for Zavala. And on now to Arunavich, who started off this series with a 9.4.
Zavala is doing really well for her first final.
Yeah, absolutely. There we go, 10.2 for Arunavich. And Franquette starting off at 8.7 and followed by a 9.2. This isn't really like her shooting. She's usually shooting up in the tens.
Mm-hmm.
And so I'd like to know what's going on. Guo with a 9.9 and one more shot to go. What would you say, Hina, would be the break-off point of, or not the best shot, but what you don't want to shoot? From what point on do you not want to shoot?
I think you do not want to shoot under 9.7.
Okay.
Yeah.
So we're seeing that quite a bit, actually.
9.8 or 9.7.
Mm-hmm. So let's take a look. Whoa, we've got Zavala has now overtaken Kim by 4/10 of a point. That's really amazing. Arunavich is still holding on to third place. She's only 4/10 of a point behind Kim. And we have Guo, only 2/10 of a point behind her. It is, I think, going to be between Orlovskaya and Franquette to find out who is going to be eliminated first. We've got
two more shots.
Orlovskaya, got two more shots to go, and Orlovskaya is only 4/10 of a point behind Franquette.
Yeah.
So anything could really happen between the two of these women.
Yeah.
And then there's, you know, 2.5 points separating.
That's a lot,
yeah. Separating Franquette from Zobovy.
Yeah.
But the top five contenders are pretty much very close.
Yeah. Right. Actually, top six is also reasonably close.
Yeah.
The sixth one.
Okay, let's focus back in now on Franquette. Maybe it's just the pressure of being on her home turf, you know.
Maybe.
That's more like it. 10.3 for Franquette.
Yes.
And a 10.4 for Olskaya.
So the high score of the round Guo Wenjun with a 10.6.
So we still have Zavala in first place, only by 2/10 of a point now. And we've got Olskaya 3/10 of a point now behind Franquette. And this is going to be the shot that's going to determine who is going to be eliminated first. Like you were saying before, you know that feeling. It's probably not a good feeling at all.
Yes. I think somewhere, you know, it's a little cruel. You know, in the old finals, maybe you thought that, okay, I can do well, I've got shots. But once you're eliminated, it's gone.
Exactly.
Yep. You don't get the chance to come back.
Mm-mm.
Yeah.
Okay, again, back on to Franquette. She is holding on to seventh place by 3/10 of a point.
I think she should cancel.
She is a little bit shaky, a 9.8, and in fact, you were right about that. That unfortunately is going to be it for her. Orlskaya has overtaken Franquette, and we're going to have to say goodbye, unfortunately, to Sonia Franquette. We'll be going into a couple more shots now. We have Zavala holding on to first place only by 1/10 of a point now over Kim. Guo has overtaken Arunavic, and Arunavic is 6/10 of a point behind. Now we're going to really have to take a look at Orlskaya because she's 1.7 tenths of a point and in the hot seat right now. 1.7 tenths of a point is really hard to make up.
Yeah. If you notice, after the fifth position, fifth position, there's a sudden drop in scores.
Yes.
It's because of the pressure of elimination, as I see it.
Okay. Gabavi with a 10.4.
Stop.
Nice. A 10.8 for Orlskaya. She really is. She knows where she is standing here, and we've
but
got a 10.0.
It's going to be quite difficult to come back because she's 1.3 points behind the sixth position.
Exactly.
It's difficult to cover that in just one shot.
Zavala still holding on to first place, and this is the next shot is going to determine who is going to be finishing up in seventh place. And like you were saying, that's really kind of hard for her to make that up. And a 9.2. That's not going to help things out at all with Gabriel. Gabriel with a 10.3. Whoa, that is pretty tough. We're going to have a chance to talk about some things here. But in the first, right now, we do have to say goodbye to Galina Orlskaya, the Russian Federation. Good for her for getting into this final in the first place. Unfortunately, it's just not enough. And things have changed around drastically. We have Kim, who has now moved down into fourth place after shooting in the seven ring. Zavala still holding in first place. She's made a little bit of a lead here. She's 6/10 of a point behind. And we've had to take a look now at Shaika. She's 7/10 of a point behind Gobavi. I think 7/10 of a point is, you could
yes.
do it.
Yes.
And Shaika has been in many, many competitions, many, many finals before.
Yeah.
And so I think she knows how to deal with the stress.
Yes. She won the gold in the last competition. Okay. She seems to be in a good form.
She sure does. And she just shot a 10.3. And she definitely has helped some things out here. Unfortunately, we've got Zavala, who shot an 8.9, that's going to change, and it has changed her standings drastically. And we had Gabravi with a 9.9. Now there's only 3/10 of a point separating Shaika from Gabravi. And so anything can happen here.
Yes, we've got 9 shots. Zavala can still come up.
We have Gao holding on to first place now, and she has a 1-point lead over Arunavic and Zavala, who are now tied up for second place. So it's really right now between Shaika and Gobavi. Coming off of a 9.9. Oh, with an 8.2.
And an 8.4 from Wen Jun.
Unbelievable. These are pretty surprising.
Yeah.
A perfect 10.9 for Shaika. And with that perfect 10.9, that overtakes Golovy. Like we said, the shot is 8.2. And we're going to be moving on to the two shots who are going to determine fifth place. And this is between Shaika, who is 0.3 of a point behind Shaika. Aronovich has now made the leap. She's moved up into first place. She's overtaken Gao, and she's 0.5 a point now in the lead.
I don't like Zavala coming down. I was growing fond of her.
Oh. Okay, Aronovich, she knows where she's standing. She's heard the scores. Let's just see if she can keep it up. She's been wanting to have a gold medal interview with me for a while now, so maybe today is her day.
Oh, she's not happy with it.
No, a 9.7. And we have Kim with a 9.4.
She's not happy either.
No. A 10.8 for Zavala. She's pretty happy with that. She's moved up into first
place. I'm happy
too. Yes. A 9.0 for Guao has moved her now down into fifth place. Only 0.1 of a point behind Shaika. And only 0.4 of a point is Shaika behind Kim. So really, anything can happen on this last shot to find out who's going to be going home in fifth place. The pressure is definitely on Guao right now, coming off a 9.0. She looks a little bit shaky there.
No, that is normal.
Okay. 10.3.
Yeah.
A 10.3, and that 10.3 overtakes Shaika, who shot a 9.4. So we're unfortunately going to have to say goodbye to Victoria Shaika, finishing up in fifth place. We've got a tie now for first place between Aronovich and Zavala. And only 0.2 of a point behind them, we have Kim. So we've got 0.9 of a point separating Guo from Kim. 0.9 of a point, what do you think? Is that enough? You could do it?
In two shots, yes.
Yeah?
Okay. Yes, you can do it. But both of them are really good shooters, so anything can happen.
Yeah. Let's focus in now on Kim. Everyone's taking their time this time to shoot. 10.5 for Guao. That's a really great shot.
Yeah.
And waiting on now Aronovich. 10.3. Very respectable shot by Aronovich. And we have Guao now 0.4 of a point behind Zavala. Kim has now moved up into second place, and Aronovich is holding on to first place by herself. This is really, really tight right now.
Yeah.
And this is the toughest shot, I think, of the final,
yeah,
because it determines who's going to be on the podium and who's, yeah, going to be going home in fourth place.
Nobody wants to go out.
No, and you can see that with the scores right now.
Yeah.
It's just 0.1 of a point.
I think Wen Jun can do it.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. I think she's really coming up in the last three, four shots. Yeah.
And things have been happening all week long, you know, during the rifle and pistol scores. You think,
yeah,
you know who's going to be on the highest step at the podium,
yeah,
and then the one shot,
yes,
is all done.
20 shots are a lot.
Mm-hmm.
You can do anything in 20 shots. You can go down and then come up and then go down and then get eliminated.
Okay, let's take a look now between Guao and Zavala. 10.2 for Zavala.
Oh,
and a 9.6 for Guao. That's not going to do it. It's getting very tight right now, and unfortunately, we're going to have to say goodbye to Wen Jun Gao from the People's Republic of China. Just wasn't enough to keep her in. We now know who is going to be going for the medals between Arunavic and Zavala, who are now tied up neck to neck. And Kim is in third place. She's a half a point behind the two tied up women. Half a point is definitely doable, and Kim is very, very talented. All these women are very talented.
That's a
9.7 for Kim.
She's not happy.
No, what a 9.1 for Arunavic. Nobody is happy at all. So, wow, we've got a tie now for second place between Arunavic and Zavala, and only 1/10 of a point separating the two tied women with Kim. This is just...
The tension is actually palpable. You can feel it.
Yeah, absolutely.
Yeah. All three of them. The body language shows that they're all nervous and they want to do something. Let's see what they do in the next shot.
Let's see if they can get back into the 10 ring for this shot that will decide who is going to win the bronze. It's true, you can really cut the tension.
Yeah. The crowd is getting a little too excited
exactly.
as well.
Exactly. Kim coming off of a 9.7, currently in first place by 1/10 of a point. Oh, 9.2.
Oh. That's a good shot.
And a 10.2 for Arunavic. Very nice shot. That has bumped her right up into first place. And we're going to have to say congratulations to Jangmi Kim from the Republic of Korea. She's winning the bronze medal. And now we're going to be going off into the last two shots to find out who will be winning the gold today. 7/10 of a point is now separating Arunavic from Zavala. And you're already squeezing your shoulders. I think that you're feeling a little bit tense for these women.
Yes. I think Zarana will do it because she seems strong right now.
She does. And you know,
she's gotten back her ground.
She was at the...
Oh, that's a bad shot.
Oh. That's a good shot.
Yeah, but I think she called it... I mean... The way she shot, she wasn't expecting a 10.2.
No.
She was lucky in this shot, I guess.
So nothing has changed. We still have 7/10 of a point after both these women have shot a 10.2. You know, Zarana has just came back from Turkey, and she ended up having food poisoning.
Oh.
And she was having a very hard time at the beginning of this of the week here. And I said to her the other day when she won bronze, I said, maybe food poisoning actually works with you. She was feeling very, very weak, but I think that her strength is definitely back here. One more shot to see who will be going home with the gold, and I know that Zarana is very, very hungry for this gold.
I think both of them are.
Absolutely.
That's a first final. Oh.
10.4 for Zavala. Very nice shot. Oh, and a 9.6 for Arunavic. Unbelievable.
Alejandra.
Zavala winning by 1/10 of a point on the last shot.
This was great.
That was really, really great.
That's the thing about pistol shooting, you know? You can still come back.
Oh, she's feeling a little bit emotional, I think, right there. And there she is, our gold medalist, Alejandra Zavala from Mexico, doing a fantastic job grabbing the gold on the last shot. And let's just see, there's our silver medalist, Zorana Arunavic from Serbia, winning her second medal here during our time here, a bronze and now a silver. Hina, thank you very, very much for joining me today. I wish you the best of luck for the future.
Thank you, the pleasure was all mine.
Okay, and congratulations on your marriage.
Thank you very much.